fun fact of the day.
Today's fun fact. You're on the moon, right? It actually has earthquakes, which they call moonquakes. So, you know, it's just in there like shaking. Shaking.
Welcome back, Blue Devils. I'm Grace.
I'm Morgan.
And you're watching the BDU. Some changes to MHS. We caught up with Principal Brown to get more details.
Hey, my name is Luke Brown and I'm the new principal here at Mooresville High School. We just got approval from the Board of Education last week to start bringing kids back to campus, and so we're in the process of developing a plan to be able to bring up to 25% capacity of all of our students back on campus on Wednesdays. We are working on the details of exactly how we will choose which students come back. There will be a survey that goes out to parents later this week to show intention. If they don't want their kids back on campus yet, then we can definitely take those kids off the list. However, we want to provide an opportunity for all the kids at some point in time in the second 9 weeks to get back on campus, get remediation in places that they need help with, have some peer interaction. And as a part of this, we're also going to be able to crank up our athletic programs for workouts and preparation for the sports year, and also have an opportunity to get our clubs on campus and organizations, band, the arts, those kind of things, ROTC. So we're excited about the opportunity to start getting kids back on campus. It's been a long 5 months, 4 months being the principal of a new school and not meeting any students. I'm ready to have you guys back.
Seniors, make sure you order your cap and gown. Do it now. Go to this website to order it.
The spring class schedule should be available on Mitchell's website mid-October.
Mitchell will email registration directions to student Mitchell email accounts in October.
Now is a great time to check your program evaluation to see what classes you can take.
Log in to WebAdvisor, select students and program evaluation.
Ms. Justice will share more information through campus announcements and on the BDU.
Please email her if you have any questions.
Trivia time.
Today's trivia question is, what was the name of the rat in Ratatouille? A. Remy. B. Ratatouille. C. Gerald. And D. Bob. If you chose A, you are correct. If you didn't, you gotta go watch the movie.
Hi everyone, so today I'm here with
Miss Melina.
And you're going to teach us some yoga poses and meditation methods to help us de-stress during virtual learning.
Okay, so first pose is mountain pose. And for this one, you literally just stand nice and tall, shoulders up, down, and hands out. And you just stand here. Take your time to breathe. Exhale. Good. So this is a great starting pose. And from here, you bring your arms up overhead. And you can forward fold. And just take deep breaths here. Great for your lower back, great for your hamstrings. We're sitting a lot. Good for us. Okay?
So there is a really quick sequence that you can do, really quick flow. And you can always add something.
I want to share something with you in case you're feeling stressed. There is an analogy that I like to think about. I was living on my own when I was 15. My parents weren't around, my father had passed away. And life can get stressful. When you're driving a car, what do? You don't look straight down, right? You're not looking down at the road underneath you. You're looking ahead. Because if you look straight down, you'd crash. And yet a lot of us, that's what we do. We kind of look straight down and we think about what we're going through at the moment. And then we end up crashing. And so what I want to challenge each of you to do is to keep your eyes on what's ahead. You know what's around you. You've got it in your peripheral and it's gonna all work out. But don't keep looking straight down. Look ahead and I promise you, it will get better.
There will be a drama club meeting Monday, October 5th at 2 p.m. Go to this link or sign up for the Remind. Fellowship of Christian Athletes holds their virtual meeting every Monday at 8 a.m. If you would like to join, here's the Google Meet link.
Yo, what's up? My name is Will Roth. I am part of the History Club. We do a little bit of everything important to history. We appeal to anyone who likes history or likes to have fun. So if you are interested, please contact me or one of the other three officers. Hope to see you there.
The MHS Diversity Ambassadors are holding a Culture Week next week. Hear more details.
The week of October 5th through 9th, the MHS Diversity Ambassadors are throwing a Culture Week. How it works is that each day there will be a different region of the world that we will be focusing on. Monday is Latin American Culture Day, Tuesday is Asian Culture Day, Wednesday is African Culture Day, Thursday is European Culture Day, and Friday is North American Culture Day. Obviously, each of these regions contain many different cultures, but we split them up as such in order to spread the event over a full week and give us an opportunity to spotlight many different aspects of each of these regions. This is where you come in. We need your help to create content for each of these days. If you can cook a special meal, do a dance, or even make a video sharing some of the facts about your culture, that would be great. The hub for all the content will be our Instagram page, which you can find at MHS Diversity Ambassadors. DM us anything you make that you would like to share. We hope to see you there.
In honor of Black Energy Awareness Month, there will be a free virtual Youth Energy Academy on October 17th on a Saturday from 10 to 2. This event will be open to all high school students to increase their knowledge on energy industry. Visit this website to register. It's time to spotlight some students and classes.
I got a call back from The Voice over the summer. Process was fairly simple. This is a short snippet of You Don't Even Know Me by Fosia. I don't care at all, he said, she said, over it. You're acting like you're brilliant, but you don't know. Yeah, you don't know. Oh, you don't know a thing at all. You don't know about the way I am when I am all alone. You don't even know.
Visual design is a graphic design class that we teach here at Mooresville High School. We certify in three different programs that Adobe offers: Illustrator, Photoshop, and InDesign. Right now we have finished up our self-portrait in Illustrator, and we are moving on to Photoshop and just doing the introduction to Photoshop right now. During our virtual lessons, we usually demo and go over notes of whatever the technique is that we're going to be using in the project. And then they use their time asynchronously at home to do the project actually on the software. We've been able to download the programs onto their laptops, which has been very helpful.
Hi, I'm Kalea.
And I'm Megan.
We're this year's Editors-in-Chiefs for the yearbook.
It's definitely a lot harder to get the photos, and you can't really make a spread without the pictures. But we have a group of very hardworking people, and we are thinking of many creative ways to pull this all together.
So you guys would say that COVID has hindered the yearbook?
Yeah. Make sure that you're submitting your baby pictures in Canvas, and you're also keeping an eye out for senior ad sales. Make sure you keep a lookout for senior superlative times to come. Take your pictures if you want a superlative.
You guys can also contact us through the Instagram if you have any interesting hobbies or things you want us to take pictures of and interview you for.
The yearbook needs seniors to submit their baby pictures as soon as possible.
You can submit pictures through yearbook Snap, or you can email Ms. Phillips directly at this email.
Also, the sale of senior ads is extended into the first quarter. Let's check out this week's MHS sports update.
Arnold Melodge, and I'm here with
Coach Nixon.
He's your Blue Devil football coach. So where are you from?
I'm from Clayton, North Carolina.
How's your connection with the players?
I think it's good. You know, we haven't had a whole lot of time together in person because of COVID, but I think we're building really good relationships right now.
Real quick. State championship coming home this year, man. Party at the Pop.
Legendary Pop.
Yes, sir.
Are you excited to be at MHS? And what are you guys doing to prepare for the season?
Yes, we're very excited. You know, we're excited we get a chance to be out here and get back to work. And, you know, hopefully come February, our guys will be prepared to party at the Pop.
This is Ethan Brewer, one of our MHS swimmers.
Something I'm doing to stay in shape for a swim is just about every other day. I wake up at 5 in the morning and swim for an hour and 30 minutes. But if you don't have a pool or anything, you can do cardio like running or something like that just to get your blood flowing. Because I think pools is probably the best thing to do, but if you don't have a pool, running is just the next best thing. Practices will be starting on the beginning of November. I think November 2nd is the date. Like definitely, even if you're not much of a swimmer, like you still need the people. Definitely recommend coming out. Like it's a nice, good family, nice team, and yeah, have a lot of fun together at meets, and definitely a Chick-fil-A after. And we'll be looking forward to seeing you guys.
It's October. We're so excited about Halloween coming up.
We're hoping everybody can have a little bit of fun and stay safe.
We're gonna have a great spooky season.
Woo!
For watching the Blue Devil Update.
Make sure you guys are following us on Instagram and Twitter at Blue Devil Update.
See you next Thursday in advisory.
Orlette,
learning.
Go to tutoring, wake up early, try to get some rest, drink coffee in case you fall asleep or something.
I'm usually using my planner so I can know when my due dates are for homework.
What you really have to do is just go to class and pay attention and do all the assignments and just make sure you're not falling far behind.
Keeping in touch with my friends and family has helped me to stay positive.
Write all your assignments that you have that week. So I have this journal right here that I just keep all my assignments in, and then I cross them off as I finish them.
My advice to anyone who is truly struggling in online school, don't procrastinate.
If you ever have a teacher that gives you homework by the weekly and posts all of the week's work, try to get it all done early, because then you have one full class that you don't have to worry about for the rest of that week.
I have sticky notes on my desktop that has all my work written down on it. And then once I do it, I like check it off or like erase it.
I stay focused. I have a desk that I sit at. I don't sit in my bed. And I try to stay away from my phone as much as possible.
I started keeping a planner. Look at this, it's very cute, I love it. So I write down what time I have each class, what time I have club meetings, what time I have work.
Set like little goals for yourself. So like for me, I try and like get a certain amount of things done in a certain amount of time, and then I like almost like a reward system. So it like you have something that I look forward to, whether it's going to soccer practice, going to work, whatever it may be, just something to keep me motivated.
My advice to be successful in online learning is to finish stuff the day it's assigned. So if you get assigned an assignment in class, you don't finish it up that day so you don't get behind, it doesn't pile up, and you're not doing it all on Friday night midnight.
What has helped me with online learning the most is being able to write down what I need to do for that day and being able to complete it on time, on my own time pretty much.
If you just start paying attention a lot more and you focus, it's not that hard of work, but it is more difficult to pay attention to when you're distracted by everything in your room. So just try and go to a different location. That really helps a lot.